पन्नपारिजाताय तोत्रमेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः. नाउ श्लोक नंबर 2 and 3 फ्रॉम भगवद गीता चैप्टर 1. संजय उवाच दृष्ट्वा तु पांडवानीकं व्यूढ़ं दुर्योधनस्तदा आचार्यमुपसंगम्य राजा वचनमब्रवीत पश्यैतां पाण्डुपुत्राणां आचार्यमहतीं च मूं व्यूढां द्रुपदपुत्रेण तव शिष्येण धीमता. As we said in the last session, the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita introduces many individual personalities. Because every personality differs according to their nature. A nature is established, given infrastructure by our mind, psychological system. This psychological system means we can divide into 2 categories. One is called mind, that which is endowed with emotions. You cannot find any mind that which is away or without emotions. Even we cannot divide life from emotions. We have to have the emotions. But the thing is, we should not be victimized by the emotions. And one more aspect, we call it buddhi. Bhagavad Gita itself, it will discuss elaborately of these old subjects. Bhagavad Gita is a great psychological text. In fact, where psychology ends, Bhagavad Gita begins. That's my opinion, understanding too. Now here, you see in these words, in the last words, 2 characters were introduced. One was Dhritarashtra, who questioned his charioteer Sanjaya. And Sanjaya, who endowed with Sattva Guna, he knows what he expects. Being a father, he is worried, and being a king, he was worried. But they had Bhishmacharya, Dronacharya, Kripacharya, Ashwatthama like a great, great, great legends with him. Still they are worried. This Sanjaya introduces Duryodhana, or Duryodhana is introduced by Acharya Vyasaji. Now who is this Duryodhana? Duryodhana is the eldest son of Dhritarashtra. He was crowned as a king. The name Duryodhana itself, it is Dukhena Yudhyate Asau. Very difficult to fight with him. He is that much strongest. Physically, he is very strong. But when it comes about the psychological system, so there where we have to understand who is this person. You know, most of the time, we judge people according to their physical appearance. And if we are a little bit more intelligent enough to see their outcoming, then we can judge who they are. If we have little bit wise enough to judge or to understand people according to their gunas, nature, then we will get more understanding too. Now here, so when he introduces Duryodhana, Duryodhana was approaching his Acharya. Acharya means what? Master. Who taught all kinds of knowledge to not only Duryodhana, not only Kuru, Kauravas, even to the Pandus. Same Acharya, that Acharya's name is Drona. Now Drona Acharya was there, but he was not the commander, he was not the Dalapati, Senadhipati, but still he approached him instead of approaching Bhishmacharya. It shows his childishness, immaturity. Because children, when they study at school, they fight with each other and they complain to the teacher. Teacher, he is pinching me, prickling me, poking me. That's the nature of the student. It's a young kid can do it, but being a king, one should have the personality. That personality means it should know how to make the decision. It should know that which governs the understanding of all current present situation. Now we can find a similarity between his father and him. Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana, both were physically so fit, very strong people. It is said Dhritarashtra, who had the strength of 100 elephants, and he too, Duryodhana, is too very difficult to fight with him. Nobody can beat. So being a very strongest people, both of them were not having a common quiet psychological system. They were restless. And they are mostly overwhelmed or victimized by emotions. Being a father, he was sitting in the courtyard and worried about son. You can see restlessness there. And where in the position, the Duryodhana is in the position to lead the army, but he is a little bit confused. By seeing these opposite people, he got something, you know, that low self-esteem, less confident. Something happened inside. Therefore what? Like a kid, he goes to Acharya. That approaching itself shows his immaturity, lack of decision-making capacity. Acharyam upagamya. That self-esteem, the lack of confidence, that also comes as the words. That's what here, Pashyetam, in the next verse it is pointed out, Pashyetam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum. Oh master, look at there. Look at the opposite side. Look at that army. Look at that huge, mighty army. But truthfully speaking, these Duryodhana's army is huger than Pandava's army. But psychologically, this person who is overwhelmed by the fear, so he cannot see the real thing what it is. Now, out of fear, he says, Mahatim Chamum. And not only that, he says, Vyudhan Drupada Putrena Tavasyashyena Dhimata. Dronacharya has got an enemy. That's what, you know, this chapter, it introduces many characters. And all those characters, they have their own likes and dislikes, and they have their own vengeance. That's what the life is. Every character is connected with each other, and all this that contemporary of people have been divided into two sides. And these people, Pandu side means this Pandava side people are connected with each other, and this Duryodhana people are connected with each other somehow. There can be blood relationship, there can be friends or relatives or business relatives and neighbors. All together, that's what the life is. We are not alone. But usually we have our feeling, I am alone. That loneliness, every one of us, we feel. But Shastra says, you are not alone. We cannot be alone because we are a part of this universe. Because the physical body is connected with the nature. This world is made up of five elements, but this body also made up of five elements. But still we fear. We have the feeling that I should have something for me. I don't have people. Being born in India, you are endowed with family. But being with family, you feel that loneliness. It means what? Something went wrong. Something went wrong where? Where it is wrong? What went wrong? That lack of understanding of the self becomes a huge problem. Because the self-realization plays a vital role. There where the problem comes. Now Duryodhana, see, he was a very strongest personality, but being very strongest personality, but he talks like a child. Going and complaining to the Acharya. Is it the way a king should approach? King should have present the orders? He should have been the king. He should have made a decision. He should have called him Acharya. Now he is not Acharya. Though the respect inside, now they are in the battlefield. He should know what to be done. And also we can see, you know, you look at that great army. This mind has got the weakness. Because the human being, we have varieties of strengths. That strength, it is said bhujabalam. Bhujabalam means the strength of muscles. The mind, if you are strongest person, bodybuilder, then you will have the confident. That confident is constructed by the muscles. Therefore, we call it bhujabalam. Then the next one is vittabalam. Vittabalam means what? That strength, that which is constructed by the assets. If you have more wealth, more assets, then you have your confident high, rise in confident. Then the third one is janabalam. If you have more people, if you have more people to support you, you are very strongest person. That is the feeling you will have. This bhujabalam, vittabalam, janabalam. That weakened mind will depend on these three. Now Duryodhana seems to be like that. We have to realize. And Duryodhana is not the past personality. Even the mind which depends on these things, that is equal to Duryodhana. That's what two more balas also introduced in our Shastra. One is called Anusthana Balam. Anusthana Balam means it's Adrishtam. Adrishtam means it's invisible. When you go to the temple, when you follow certain rituals, fire rituals, or you do japa, meditation, all this will provide Punya Phala. That's what called Anusthana Balam. That anusthanable, if you construct the temple, you will become confident. And that too is a secondary strength. That first foremost strength is called Atmabalam. This anusthanabalam is also dependent on karma, action. It cannot give eternal strength. Now, when you believe on something, that something won't give according to your expectations, then what? You are cheating yourself. We have to know the nature of the object. We have to know the life of that object, strength of that object, then alone we have to believe. That Duryodhana has the same mentality. So he is not using buddhi, intellect. Intellect alone will judge, will decide which is what. because intellect has the capacity to think about past and present and future. Because the experience which we have in our life, this body is, you know, keep on growing. It will grow to be old. Now buddhi, so as you grow, buddhi should also should have that expansion to realize the factors. So when the buddhi fails, then problem begins. Now atma balam means that atma bala which is constructed by shastra, by the realization of the self. When you realize yourself, you are nothing but completeness, purnatvam, purnoham. That has to be the realization. I am adequate person. My personality is adequate one. Then you can communicate properly. Your communication will be transferred into completeness. Whatever the outcoming comes in the form of word, in the form of action, everything will show that completeness. Now Duryodhana, being a lack of personality or being weakened mind, so he wants to, psychologically he is dependent on all those things which is not eternal. Now this is the personality. Duryodhana is a main person. Being immature from the childhood, he was having vengeance, jealousy on Pandavas. Instead of having jealousy, he should have been focused on his life. He would have been a different personality in this history. Okay, so now the way he speaks with Acharya, either he should have been, you know, very respectful, full personality with Acharya, but he didn't do that. He was provoking, the intention to provoke Acharya, that's what is seen in his words. He said, look at there, your enemy's son. These armies which is formed by him. And also he adds the adjective, which is formed very intelligently. It means what? He is provoking Acharya, your disciple, Drupadasya putraha, Drishtadyumnaha. One more character and two more characters. Drupadaha, Drupadasya putraha. The son of Drupada. Drupada, Drona and Drupada, they were friends in the childhood. Then they had something between, then enmity began. Because all the enemies, so who were there in the form of friends. Now his sign, but who studied under him, he is an opposite side, that's what this Duryodhana wants to pinch him and provoke him. You see, the Drishtadyumna, the army which is formed by Drishtadyumna. Then he continues next words. Atra Shura Maheshvasaha Bhima Arjuna Samayudhi Yuyudhano Viratascha Drupadascha Maharathaha. Atra, in their formation, in their sight, there are unrivaled people, personalities. Then Maheshvasaha, Mahantaha, Ishvasaha, Dhanudharinaha, Yete. The people who possess the greater bows, mighty bows, and they are equal to Bhima and Arjuna. Now you see, so he thinks about Bhima always, because he knows Bhima is equal to him, that Bhima could defeat him. Therefore what? Bhima, Arjuna, Sama, Yudhi. Yudhi means in the battle, these people are equal to Bhima and Arjuna's. And one more personality, Yuyudhanaha, Viratah, Drupadah, Maharathah, Drupadah. All of them were a great personalities. Now, introducing these personalities, we should realize one thing. We are also endowed with all those personality around us, our karma phala. Our karma phala is because, you know, according to Bhagavad Gita, I have to point here, you know, either we should have an elaborate introduction with the stories and all, or we should go verse by verse and side by side we have to give more information. Now, this first six chapter, they elaborate about personality, individual personality. See, now if you are an individual personality, you are connected with your relatives and you are connected with your friends, even with enemies, and these all people around you are nothing but the outcoming or fruit of your own karma phala. Because this body, we have got this body is because of our karma phala, because of the result of our past action. Not only this body, the shariras around this body is also because of karma phala, and the experiences with them, whatever that we experience, that is nothing but our karma phala. That is the proper perception, proper approach with the individual personality. So when you think, wherever we go, you know, the people ask, how old are you? How old are you? Because you are informed your birthday. You were not aware. We were not aware. Is there anybody that who could say that, yes, I was born exactly 6:20 in the morning in this month on that year? Nobody. We are informed. We are informed of date of birth, date of death, and the particulars about relatives. Even we are given the names. We are given the names. And that names also not given for our sake. Maybe later on, but our parents, they named us for their convenience to do transaction with you. And even for your convenience, you can do transaction. Wherever you go, people ask, who are you? You can say that your name and your bio data, all the bio data, what they ask, you know, where you were born and what's your father's name, everything related to this physical body. Therefore, the Shastra has got, you know, it has got a deep perception. It has got penetrating research. I'm not only this body. This body is not my beginning. Then, what causes for this body to begin? Was there anything left out before the body? That's the connection. So when I realized, so because when I was born in a particular situation, environment, that while being born itself, it is fixed particular language, region, religion, and people around, and the culture around you, we take 15, 20 years to get settled with all that outer things to learn. Once we are aware about where it began, we can sort out any problem that we face in our life. That is the target of Bhagavad Gita. Now, introducing all this personality for the sake of our understanding, to prepare us for what? To prepare us for our life, prepare us to give a proper realization about the self. That's what the glory of Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, we need not to get boredom by studying this characteristic. You may find these characters are nothing to do with my life, No, it's not like that. All the characters, they have their own stories. If you want to get that stories, you can read, you know, these all histories are available. We focus on the content, what to be consumed as a teaching. That's what our content. We will also continue in the next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.